we think about our business, we think about it in three buckets. You've got the core business, which is what we've defined as motion control, and that's the products that people know Parker by. And the world needs those products, so that's great. That's the foundation of our company, and that's not going to change. But we see a lot of opportunity in adjacent markets, new markets. An example of that would be medical. Could those technologies be applied in new ways in the medical space? And the answer is yes. And then the last bucket that we like to think about is services. How do you deliver that product? Did you have a presence online? Was it easy to find information? Was it easy to buy it? But then there's all this after sale experience piece that we've really focused on, which is around services. That was one of the biggest changes, I believe, in the Win Strategy Refresh, was the focus on the entire customer experience. And is there things that we can do to our products where devices start to connect and are capable of streaming data back to a central place where it can be processed? And you can gain insight into what works and what doesn't work to improve the experience. A lot of the insight that we'll gain from streaming all this data back helps us make better products. The Airbus A350 is a wide-body aircraft. They've sold over 750 orders from over 40 different airlines around the world. So a very successful platform. It's just entering service now, but it's Parker's largest bill of material on any commercial jetliner to date. A lot of software is used to control the various systems on the aircraft. So there are system upgrades. Those are opportunities for us to improve the customer experience, improve the product. Commercial aircraft have a very long life cycle, about 30 years. So we expect to enjoy the benefits of these wins far into the future. Smart Tool is new for us. Some of the first customers for this device thought so much of it that they started creating YouTube videos on their own to tell other people about it. So in this case, this was a technician that would be servicing your air conditioning in your home. What our team did was they took these wireless sensors and they made a wireless gauge set that the technician now connects, so all the hose and piping that had been common in the procedure is gone. They turn it on. That information streams to their smartphone or their iPad. There's an app on the device that does all the calculations for them. They can also then send a report to the customer or back to the office that gives the homeowner some confidence that whatever was done correctly, and there's data to support it. Most of the products that we manufacture end up in very critical applications. Could be on an oil rig, could be in a mine, where if the products go down, it can create a safety issue, and for sure, at the very least, it will cost a lot of money while the product is not operational. So anything we can do to guarantee uptime is really important to our customers. So the idea of tagging, they look like barcodes that are on things like hoses so that we know exactly what the hose is, we know when it was born. If something were to happen to it, we can literally, there's an app, we can take a photo of the barcode that can be sent to a distributor or dealer and a replacement can be made. We've been doing this now for several years. There are literally millions of asset tags out there now. As the number of tags increases, the value of the information increases. It's a mechanical version, really, of the Internet of Things that's created incredible value for our customers, and they see it. Services is the piece of our business where, historically, when we think about innovation, we think about products. This is a big, big area with big potential upside for the company, and you'll see more and more products that are focused on service and the entire user experience. The really great news is, despite all the economic headwinds we faced in 2005, it was a really good year for product innovation at Parker. We grew sales of products that had been launched in the fiscal year and in the previous 5 years, double digits. The future's looking very bright, and our portfolio of products that are in development has never been healthier. We have over 1,200 projects in various stages of development right now inside the company. So we're real bullish on the future, and some of these projects have scale. They're big. It'll take time for them to mature and to recognize the mature sales that will result from them, but there's clear evidence that we're on that path. The face of the company is changing. The world around us is changing. We need to change faster. We think we've positioned ourselves well to do that, and I think we're up to the challenge.